Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are discussing about types of polymer reactions: hydrolysis, acidolysis, aminolysis, addition reaction, hydrogenation, etc. So first, hydrolysis. What is hydrolysis? Hydrolysis means addition of water molecule into the polymer chain, and this water molecule divide the polymer chain into different types of polymer chain. Water dissolve this polymer and divide this polyamide into different amide polymer and different carboxylic polymer. Acidolysis means addition of acid into the polymer chain. We add acid into the polymer chain, and this acid degrade the polymer into different types of polymer. We incorporate dicarboxylic alkyl acid, and this acid divide this polymer into one acid polymer and another base polymer. Aminolysis. Aminolysis means addition of base into the polymer chain, and this base degrade this polymer chain into different types of polymer chain. Here you can see this is another polyamide, yeah, the same polyamide polymer, incorporate diamine alkyl, and this diamine alkyl degrade this polymer in base polymer and another acid polymer, or two base polymer or two acid polymer. Next, addition reaction. Addition reaction means added some molecules into the polymer chain, and these molecules change the polymer structure, change the polymer properties, behavior, etc., etc. Polyisoprene, we added ozone, and this ozone create a ozonide group, ozonide structure, into ozonide structure with react with the double bond of polyisoprene, and this ozonide structure is unstable, so this ozonide structure degrade and release one hydrogen peroxide and create two different type of polymer chain. So here ozone by addition reaction, polyisoprene degrade by the reaction of ozone. Next, polyisoprene chlorine added, chlorine react with polyisoprene, you can see here, and this created different type of polymer. This is not polyisoprene, but chlorine here don't degrade the polyisoprene, but it change the properties of the polymer. Final product which is different from polyisoprene and it's different from polyisoprene nature. So the physical properties of polyisoprene is different from its final product after chlorination. To the polyisoprene chain, we incorporate hydrogen, and this hydrogen here don't break the polymer chain, but it's create ethylene propylene copolymer. So ethylene propylene copolymer is different from polyisoprene. So ethylene propylene copolymer properties also different from polyisoprene. So here hydrogen change the polyisoprene properties and make a different type of copolymer. This reaction we called hydrogenation reaction also. If you like my video, please like and share among your all friends, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos. Thank you for watching.